My beloved brothers and sisters, within each of us is a divine power that often remains dormant or unnoticed. In a world where our words shape our reality, we have the ability to create blessings or challenges for ourselves through what we say. Today, I want to explore with you the incredible power of speaking blessings over your life, a practice that invites God's presence and favor into all that you do. I'll also pray a powerful prayer with you in Jesus' name. So stay with me until the end and open your heart to receive the blessings. The Bible reminds us that the words we speak hold great power, influencing both our visible world and the spiritual realm. In Proverbs 18, verse 21, it says, "Death and life are in the power of the tongue, and those who love it will eat its fruit." This truth is often overlooked. When we align our words with God's promises, we open the door to blessings. But when negativity, fear, or doubt take over, they block the blessings God intends for us. Think about the words you've spoken over yourself lately. Do they reflect trust in God, or are they influenced by life struggles? Let's explore the power of speaking blessings over ourselves. The words we use shape our paths, either bringing us closer to God's blessings or distancing us from them. Imagine your words as seeds you plant in your own life. Whatever you speak will grow, either producing blessings or burdens. Just like a farmer understands the potential of each seed, we must realize that our words hold power. Though this idea may seem unusual, it is deeply rooted in Scripture. In James 3, verse 9 to 10, we are told, "With the tongue we bless our God and Father, and with it we curse men who have been made in the likeness of God. Out of the same mouth proceed blessing and cursing." This verse shows us the dual nature of our words. They can bring life or destruction, peace or chaos. When we choose to speak blessings, we align ourselves with God's plan to enrich our lives and the lives of others. But how often do we speak blessings over ourselves? Many people pray for others, lifting them with words of faith and hope. Yet rarely do they direct that same power inward. Speaking blessings over yourself isn't selfish. It's a recognition of God's love and promises. Throughout the Bible, we see countless examples of people declaring blessings over their lives and experiencing God's faithfulness. An example of speaking blessings can be found in Psalm 16, where David confidently speaks of God's provision and guidance. He declares, "I have set the Lord always before me. Because he is in my right hand, I will not be shaken." In these words, David speaks stability and assurance into his life, affirming God's presence and blessings for his future. This declaration shows his trust in God's promises and his willingness to claim those blessings for himself. God's promises are often unlocked through faith and spoken words. He delights when his children speak in agreement with his heart. In 2 Corinthians 4, verse 13, we read, "I believed, and therefore I have spoken. We also believe, and therefore speak." This shows a deep truth. Our faith grows when we speak it out loud. When we declare God's promises, we activate that faith, allowing it to grow and bring blessings into our lives. The words we speak over ourselves show our trust in God's promises and his unchanging love. But speaking blessings isn't just about saying positive things. It's about aligning our words with the truth of God's word and inviting his presence into every area of our lives. In 1 Chronicles 4, verse 10, we see Jabez praying boldly to God, "Oh, that you would bless me indeed, and enlarge my territory, that your hand would be with me, and that you would keep me from evil, that I may not cause pain." God granted him his request. Jabez speaks confidently, asking for blessings, protection, and favor. He knows his words have power when backed by faith. How often do we approach God with such boldness, believing he wants to bless us? Jabez's prayer is more than just words. It is a statement of faith. He believes that God can and will bless him, and he isn't afraid to speak it out loud. In our own lives, We can declare blessings, protection, and favor with the same confidence, trusting that God is faithful. When we say blessings, we are not just hoping for good things to happen. We are standing in agreement with God's promises and proclaiming His goodness. Psalm 103, verse 2 says, "Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all His benefits." David speaks to his soul, reminding himself of God's goodness, mercy, and faithfulness. We too must remind ourselves of God's love and the blessings He wants to pour into our lives. Speaking blessings strengthens our faith and reminds us of our identity as God's beloved children. Our words become instruments of faith, releasing God's blessings into our lives. But maybe some of you feel unsure about speaking blessings over yourselves. Perhaps you've faced hardships or feel unworthy of God's blessings. The Bible teaches us that our value is not based on our circumstances, but on God's grace. In Romans 8, verse 38 to 39, we are reminded that nothing can separate us from God's love in Christ Jesus. This assurance gives us the confidence to speak blessings over our lives, knowing we are deeply loved and valued by Him. God wants you to experience His blessings, joy, peace, and provision. These blessings are already available to you through His promises, and speaking them over your life is a way to strengthen your faith in His Word. Each time you declare a blessing, you are affirming, "I trust you, God. I believe your promises are true, and I receive them for my life." Imagine how your life could change if you began to speak blessings over yourself every day. Picture yourself waking up each morning, declaring God's goodness, and speaking life and hope into your future. This is not just a declaration of faith, but an invitation for God to work powerfully in every part of your life. Speaking blessings is not a one-time event. It's a daily practice, a constant reminder of God's faithfulness. As we make this a habit, we become more aware of His presence and more open to His blessings. This practice aligns our hearts with God's will, allowing His promises to take root and grow in our lives. Let's remember the power of our words and the authority we have to shape our lives through the blessings we speak. Speaking blessings over ourselves is not just an act of faith, but also a powerful way to partner with God in shaping our lives. When we declare God's promises over our situations, we invite His power, love, and guidance into every aspect of our experience. This is not merely about thinking positively. It is a spiritual practice rooted in the truth of God's Word. By speaking blessings, we align our hearts with His promises, which strengthens our spirit. Consider how God instructed Joshua as he prepared to lead Israel into the promised land. In Joshua 1 verse 8, God told him, "This book of the law shall not depart from your mouth, but you shall meditate on it day and night, so that you may be careful to do everything written in it." God taught Joshua the importance of keeping His word close, letting it become a source of strength and courage. When we speak God's truth, our hearts are anchored in faith, and we walk confidently in His promises. Speaking blessings also impacts the atmosphere around us. Our words have spiritual influence. They either draw us closer to God or allow doubt and fear to creep in. When we choose to speak blessings, we invite peace, joy, and hope into our hearts and surroundings. As Paul writes in Philippians 4, verse 7, "The peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, will guard your hearts and minds through Christ Jesus." When we declare blessings, God's peace transforms our inner lives, shaping how we respond to the world around us. It's important to remember that speaking blessings is not just about changing our feelings. It's about affirming who we are in Christ and inviting God's reality to define our lives. As Paul says in Ephesians 1 verse 3 to 4, "Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has blessed us with every spiritual blessing in the heavenly places in Christ, just as He chose us in Him before the foundation of the world." This truth reminds us that God has already blessed us in many ways. Speaking blessings is a way of accepting and receiving what God has freely given us through His love. Think of your words as spiritual seeds. Each blessing you speak has the potential to grow and bring a harvest of faith, joy, and peace. In Psalm 19, verse 14, David prays, "Let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in your sight, O Lord, my strength and my Redeemer." This prayer shows the link between what we speak and the attitude of our hearts. When we choose to speak blessings, we honor God and invite His strength to work for us. At times, it may be hard to speak blessings, especially when we're facing difficulties. It can feel tough to declare God's goodness when life is challenging. But it's during these times that speaking blessings is most powerful. In 2 Corinthians 12, verse 9, Paul recalls God's words, "My grace is sufficient for you, for my strength is made perfect in weakness." Paul responds by saying, "Therefore, I will boast in my weaknesses, that the power of Christ may rest upon me." By speaking these words, Paul is choosing to see his struggles through God's grace, blessing himself with strength, even in weakness. When we declare blessings over ourselves, we're doing more than wishing for a better future. We're standing firm on God's promises, shifting our focus from life's challenges to the one who sustains us. Just as Paul embraced God's strength during his hardships, we can speak blessings that remind us of God's unchanging faithfulness. The words we speak affect not only our inner lives, but also how we respond to challenges. Imagine how your day would change if you started by declaring God's goodness. Picture waking up and saying, "Today I am blessed by God. Today I walk in His peace and protection. Today His love surrounds me." These words are a powerful declaration of faith, a reminder that we are held by a God who is greater than any circumstance. Speaking blessings over ourselves shows our trust in God's plan. Jeremiah 29, verse 11 says, "For I know the thoughts I think toward you, says the Lord, thoughts of peace and not of evil, to give you a future and a hope." By declaring blessings, we align ourselves with this hope, trusting that God is working everything for our good. Speaking blessings is a way to choose faith over fear, hope over discouragement. It strengthens our connection to God and reminds us of His presence and power. With every blessing we speak, we create space in our hearts for His peace and love to grow. As we keep doing this, we become more sensitive to God's voice and more aware of His guidance. Let us keep speaking blessings over ourselves, trusting that with every word, we draw closer to God and invite His transformative power into our lives. When we speak blessings, we're not only claiming God's promises, but also nurturing gratitude and trust. Declaring His goodness sets our minds on His faithfulness, helping us become more open to His guidance. Shifting our focus from earthly problems to divine promises creates a spirit of expectancy where we begin to look forward to God's blessings rather than fearing the future. Speaking blessings is a powerful tool in shaping our spiritual journey. The story of Abraham is a great example of someone who trusted God's promises despite the obstacles he faced. In Romans 4, verse 20 to 21, we read that Abraham didn't let unbelief shake his trust in God's promise. Instead, he grew stronger in faith, praising God, fully convinced that God would keep His word. Abraham's unwavering trust in God's promise led to blessings in his life. When we speak blessings over ourselves, we follow Abraham's example, choosing to trust in God's promises rather than focusing on our own limitations. Speaking blessings also helps us resist negativity. In a world full of discouraging words, it's easy for doubt and fear to take over. But when we speak blessings, we create a shield of faith that protects us from these influences. In Ephesians 6, verse 16, Paul tells us that faith is like a shield, able to protect us from the enemy's attacks. By declaring blessings, we equip ourselves with that shield, guarding our hearts and minds from words or thoughts that try to pull us away from God's truth. Speaking blessings is also a way to stay focused on God's presence in every season of life. It reminds us that He is with us, even in tough times. Psalm 23, verse 4 says, "Though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for you are with me, your rod and your staff. They comfort me." David understood that God's presence brings comfort and guidance, no matter the situation. When we speak blessings, we affirm that truth, growing more aware of God's closeness and His desire to guide us through every challenge. Speaking blessings is also about surrendering to God's will. When we declare blessings, we trust His plan and let go of our own desires, allowing His perfect guidance to lead us. Proverbs 16:9 reminds us, "A man's heart plans his way, but the Lord directs his steps." By blessing ourselves with words of faith, we release our need for control, trusting God to lead us in ways that bring glory to His name. Through this surrender, our lives become stories of His faithfulness. Another great outcome of speaking blessings is the joy it brings. When we declare God's goodness and promises, our spirits are lifted and our hearts fill with gratitude. Joy isn't just a reaction to good circumstances. It's a fruit of the Spirit, rooted in God's truth. In Nehemiah 8 verse 10, we read, "Do not sorrow, for the joy of the Lord is your strength." Speaking blessings taps into that joy, which strengthens us and helps us face each day with purpose and gratitude. Finally, speaking blessings over ourselves affects the people around us. When others see our faith, courage, and joy, they are drawn to the light of Christ in us. Our words have a ripple effect, inspiring others to seek God's blessings and speak life into their own situations. In Matthew 5, verse 16, Jesus tells us to let our light shine so others can see our good deeds and praise God. When we speak blessings over our lives, we become that light, showing God's love and goodness. Blessing ourselves is not just a personal act of faith. It's also a way to encourage others to trust in God's promises. Every time we declare blessings, we draw closer to God and reflect His light to those around us. Now, I invite you to pray with me or listen in faith so that you can receive the blessings of this prayer. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, I come to You with a heart full of gratitude. You are the Creator of all things, and all glory belongs to You. You spoke life into existence and created us with love and purpose. I praise You for Your holiness, justice, and faithfulness. Your mercy endures forever, and Your love reaches beyond the heavens. Thank You for Your goodness, for being my rock and redeemer. Thank You for Your love, strength, and the hope You give us. I ask for Your forgiveness, Father. Forgive me for my sins and for the times I've spoken words that didn't reflect Your truth. Help me to let go of doubt, fear, and negativity. I also forgive those who have wronged me. Cleanse my heart and help me speak words that align with Your promises. Renew my mind so I can boldly declare Your goodness and grace. Today, I declare blessings over my life according to Your word. I declare I am blessed in the city and in the field. I speak life and prosperity over all my work. You are my shepherd and I will not want. I declare You as my provider and I lack no good thing. I speak peace over my mind, knowing You will keep me in perfect peace as my mind stays on You. I declare strength over my body and spirit, for I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. I also declare favor in my relationships, believing that kindness and truth will bring favor from God and others. I speak healing into my body, knowing that by Your stripes I am healed. I declare Your protection over my life. When I dwell in Your presence, I am safe under Your shadow. I declare victory over every challenge, knowing I am more than a conqueror through Christ. I trust that everything is working for me, not against me. I receive these blessings in faith, and I speak them over my loved ones, asking for your favor, protection, and peace to surround them every day. I thank you for the hearts that are opening to you right now. We come together in prayer, trusting in your promises. Pour out your blessings on each life, bringing healing, strength, and peace. Guide us with your wisdom, love, and understanding. We declare victory over every battle, proclaiming your goodness. Thank you, Lord, for being with us and filling us with your love and strength. Let your will be done in our lives as it is in heaven. For yours is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. Thank you for hearing and answering my prayer. In Jesus' name, amen. I declare that all the blessings of this prayer are now upon you in Jesus' name. If you would like to help us spread the gospel, share this video with friends or family, and like it. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel for more videos to bless your heart and uplift your spirit. If you're listening and want to accept Jesus Christ as your Savior, pray this simple prayer. Dear Lord Jesus, I know I am a sinner and ask for your forgiveness. I believe you died for my sins and rose from the dead. I turn from my sins and invite you into my heart. I want to trust and follow you as my Lord and Savior. Thank you for saving me. Amen. Now that you've prayed this, I encourage you to fellowship with other believers, learn more about your new life in Christ, and grow closer to God. Feel free to leave your prayer requests in the comments and we will pray for you. You are not alone. Our community is praying with you. Even if you don't see a response, know that we are lifting you up in prayer, believing in the power of God to bring healing, comfort, and guidance. May the grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you all. Thank you for watching. Please like, subscribe, and turn on the notification bell to be updated whenever we post a new video. God bless you. Amen.